So as you get the overall placement of how you're doing the proportion, the height, as well as the width of it, and try to look at the overall shape. This is somewhat of a triangular piece, might have a center line into it, develop like a cone just to get some geometry into it, so you can see the beginning. And then kind of look at the shapes. You can draw it from the inside out, or the contour might help when you pick up some pieces of the snow shapes and build it up. Try to see if there's any kind of geometric structure to it. And just start to build this section. But like I said, there's a few options to choose from. Just kind of placing it in there. Any detail, just kind of look at the contour of these parts. And let that kind of help you with it, overlapping lines there. Try to look for the gesture of the tree as well, kind of the flow of it. So just kind of doing a linear part of the drawing, trying to look for some of these shapes. Shading so that when you look at it, it's got a solid distance between the black and the white, so you can kind of start to shade that in. I'm just going to hold my pencil a little bit to the side to start to look for some pieces, just to make a little looser. And if you squint your eyes, you can see the value patterns a little bit easier. The black and the white difference. And try to be subtle on these parts. It's almost like frosting on this part. And with the snow, you can see it. It has a light and a dark side, just a soft shape transition there, and that the white of the paper is going to be the brightest part of the value for the snow. And nice and crisp. So just kind of blocking it out in the first Passover, for example, has some of the section there, just as a light and a dark part. And then go back if I see some detail that I want to capture, I can go back in with some dark accents to it. Kind of looking at the edges of those dark pieces, try to find what they are, and again, you can zoom into your reference. Hopefully see it all. You can, depending on your pencil, you can turn it to the side. It's just a matter of looking at some of the detail, seeing how the snow's kind of heavy, just kind of building on itself, combining together. And again, going back in. By just clicking on getting a little more detail closer into the photo reference, it's going to help. So the snow shapes themselves have a light value to it, light tones, and then the tree is the darkest dark value. So when you think of it like a histogram, it's very complex. A little bit more detail to it. Even as you get some of the values down, you can still outline and create some of the shapes and the volumes of the snow that have a darker value to it.